In the previous video, we studied the transmission and reflection due to conductor half space, and we said that the transmission coefficient in this case it would be 1 plus gamma would equal 2 eta over eta plus eta naught. For the case of a good conductor, the value of eta would equal 1 plus j square root omega mu over 2 sigma, which can be represented as 1 plus j or multiplied by 1 over sigma multiplied by delta s, where sigma is the conductivity and delta s is the skin depth. And we said that the transmitted power through the interface from free space to the conductor media is sigma multiplied by E naught squared multiplied by the transmission coefficient squared over 4 alpha, where alpha is the attenuation coefficient, which equal 1 over delta s. Now if we study the coefficient sigma multiplied by t squared over alpha separately, so we can replace t squared by 4 eta squared over the modulus of eta plus eta naught squared, and 1 over alpha it can be replaced by delta s. So this would be sigma delta s 4 eta squared over eta plus eta naught squared. Usually the intrinsic impedance of a good conductor is much smaller than the intrinsic impedance of free space. So we can approximate eta plus eta naught to be nearly eta naught. So the denominator here can be replaced by eta naught squared. Now the value of eta itself is 1 plus j over sigma delta s. So eta squared is eta multiplied by eta conjugate, would be 1 minus j multiplied by 1 minus j, so it would be 2 over sigma squared delta s squared. So this is 2 over sigma squared delta s squared. Sigma squared delta s squared can be eliminated by the sigma delta s. So the remaining part in the denominator, it would be sigma delta s without the squared. And here we have 2. So 2 multiplied by 4 would be 8. So this there, it can be approximated as 8 over sigma delta s eta naught squared. Now we are going to replace this term in the power transferred. So the power transferred in this case would be 8 multiplied by e naught squared over sigma over 4 sigma delta s eta naught squared. So 8 over 4, it would be 2 e naught squared over sigma delta s eta naught squared. Effectively, this representation it can be simplified as 2 e naught squared surface resistance Rs over eta naught squared, where R is the surface impedance in this case is 1 over sigma delta s, which is effectively the real part of the intrinsic impedance of the conductor medium. So if we are taking the real part of eta, it would be 1 over sigma delta s, which is equal square root omega mu over 2 sigma. So the transmitted power, it can be represented into, or can be represented in terms of surface impedance, equivalent surface impedance of the conducting media, and this equivalent surface impedance is actually the real part of the intrinsic impedance. And in this case, the transmitted power is 2E naught squared over eta naught squared multiplied by the surface impedance Rs. On the other hand, we have surface current. The total current inside the conducting media is represented as sigma multiplied by the electric field. And we have shown before that the current at any point inside the conducting media it would be sigma multiplied by the magnitude of the transmitted electric field, which is T E naught multiplied by e to the power minus gamma z, and it is in the same direction of the electric field x. So to calculate the total current inside the conducting media, we can integrate this current along all the conducting media starting from 0 to infinity. So the total current would be the transmitted current Jt dot dz, where z is from 0 to infinity. So in this case it would be sigma Te naught multiplied by the integration from 0 to infinity e to the power minus gamma z dz, and gamma here is alpha plus g beta. So we have e to the power minus alpha z, so it is attenuating. So by integrating this exponential term from 0 to infinity, it would be 1 over minus gamma e to the power minus gamma z. The limit when z equal infinity would be 0. The limit when z equal 0, it would be 1. So the resulting total current would be sigma multiplied by the transmission coefficient multiplied by the amplitude of the incident electric field E naught over gamma in x direction. And it should be noted here this current is complex quantity. Okay. Now the value of sigma T over gamma, we are going to simplify it. So for large sigma, sigma T over gamma can be represented as sigma 1 over gamma is effectively 1 plus G over delta S. Gamma is 1 plus G over delta S, so 1 over gamma is delta S over 1 plus G. The transmission coefficient T would be 2 eta over eta plus eta naught. And as we mentioned, eta is much smaller than eta naught, so it can be 2 eta over eta naught. And eta is effectively 1 plus G over sigma delta S. So it would be 1 plus G over sigma delta S, which is 2 eta, over eta naught. Now by eliminating sigma with sigma, delta S with delta S, 1 plus G, 1 plus G. So the remaining part it would be 2 over eta naught. So the coefficient sigma T over gamma can be simplified as to be 2 over eta naught. So the current density or the total current inside the conductor, the total current density inside the conductor, it would be approximately 2 E naught over eta naught in x direction. Effectively, if we are talking about perfect electric conductor with sigma tends to infinity, the boundary condition which we know about the perfect electric conductor is that the surface current density G is equal N cross H at the interface, where N is the normal unit vector, which in our case is negative Z, and H is the incident or the total tangential electric field, the total tangential field at the interface, which is H incident plus H reflected. H incident plus H reflected at the interface is E naught 1 over eta naught 1 minus gamma, and gamma in the case of perfectly conductor is minus 1, so 1 minus gamma is 2. So the total current according to the boundary condition is 2 E naught over eta in x direction, which is the same as the current we have delivered by using the value of the current or the transmitted current inside the conducting media, assuming finite conductivity. And this finite conductivity is for large sigma, would be the current 2 E naught over eta naught, which is the same as the same value as the boundary condition. Okay. Now, for the case of a finite conductor of finite conductivity, and this finite conductivity is large, we have the concept of surface current and surface impedance, such that we say that the total current inside the conducting material is sigma TE naught multiplied by e to the power minus gamma z. So the current is distributed as exponentially decaying function inside the conductor material. And the equivalent surface current is 2 E naught over eta naught. The question now is, what will be the situation if we assume that the total current is concentrated in a very thin sheet, and the very thin sheet extend from the interface z equals 0 to 1 skin depth. So if we are going to assume that the current is concentrated in 1 skin depth, such that from z equals 0 to z equals delta s, and we have uniform current density, this uniform current density in this case would be the surface current Js over delta s. And after 1 skin depth, we are going to assume that the current is 0. So instead of the exact distribution of the current, which is exponential decaying function, we are going to approximate it as a uniform current inside 1 skin depth. The question now is, would this uniform current have the same dissipated power as the exponential term or not? To do this, we are saying that the dissipated power due to this uniform current distribution can be obtained as 1 over 2 sigma the integration of Js squared over delta s squared, which is a uniform current distribution, dz ds. This effectively half the resistance multiplied by the current square, and we integrate it on the volume. So the power dissipated due to this uniform current distribution is given by 1 over 2 sigma Js squared over delta s squared dz ds, and this current extend on the z direction from z equals 0 to delta s. So by making the integration on z, it would be multiplied by delta s, so it would be js squared over delta s, because it would be multiplied by delta s. Alright? Okay. And the surface area, it is assumed to be 1 meter squared, so this would be multiplied by 1 meter. Now we have 1 over delta s multiplied by 1 over sigma. 1 over sigma delta s is effectively the surface resistance of the medium. If remember, we obtained that the surface resistance is the real of eta, and real of eta, it was 1 over sigma delta s. So this is the surface resistance Rs over 2 multiplied by the current density Js squared multiplied by the surface. And as I said, we are assuming that the surface is unity. So this would be Js squared Rs over 2. Okay. And effectively, the current J surface is given by 2 E naught over eta naught. So in this case, Js squared is 4 E naught squared over eta naught. 4 over 2, it would be 2 E naught squared R surface over eta naught squared. If we remember, this is effectively the power dissipated inside the conductor half medium. So starting with a uniform current distribution equal J surface over delta S, and this uniform current distribution extend only in one skin depth, we obtain the dissipated power is the same as the power we have proved by using the power that obtained by using the exponentially decaying current density. So in this case, this is a power dissipated in terms of the equivalent surface current density and the equivalent surface resistance. And effectively, the equivalent current density Gs, it can be represented in terms of the tangential magnetic field, because effectively J surface equal N cross H. So the magnitude of J surface is exactly the magnitude of the tangential magnetic field. So we can replace the magnitude of J surface by the magnitude of H tangential, and we obtain the same result. So to calculate the dissipated power, we can calculate it by using H tangential squared multiplied by R surface over 2, or we can calculate it as 2 E naught squared over eta naught squared multiplied by the surface resistance Rs. Okay. Alright. And here we say that Rs is the real part of eta. So Rs is 1 over sigma delta S. And the surface current Gs. And the power transmitted is 2 E naught squared Rs over eta naught squared. And this power transmitted is effectively the transmitted power from medium 1 to medium 2. Okay. All right.